Hello, RAV4 friends. My name is Paul, and today I have a gift for you. You know these plastic roof rack covers that are broken in your RAV4? Well, today I made some new ones, and in this video, I'll show you how to get them.
These covers aren't removable, so don't do this unless you have some replacements. Pop the back part up with a screwdriver, then slide the cover toward the back of the car. The front part has some long tabs that hold it in place, and the back has a round clip that breaks when you remove the cover. You can kind of reinstall the cover by sliding the front in first, then working the side clips into place. The round clip in the back doesn't hold anymore, but it kind of works. I designed two new roof rack covers. The one on top covers the hole if you don't have a roof rack. The one on the bottom will be used with a roof rack. My covers have clips on both ends, so you need to flex it up in the middle to let the clips slide into place. Push down on the middle of the cover to make sure the side clips go in. To remove it, bend the cover up in the middle and pull out the front or back. The cover with the hole works the same way. Bend the middle up first and slide the front and back into place. They are removable if you're careful, but the PETG plastic I used will break if you bend it too far. Nylon is a more flexible material, so if you can use nylon instead, do it. I designed these plugs on the computer using Fusion 360 and saved them as an STL file. The STL file goes into the PRUSA slicer app. Here I tell the 3D printer what material to use and set the temperature. I'm using PETG and printing at 240 degrees Celsius. Then I export the G code onto an SD card and print the parts. I'm using a PRUSA 3D printer. It takes about 5 hours to print 4 roof plugs. This is great if you happen to own a 3D printer. I'm guessing most of you don't have one of these, so here's what you can do. First, follow the link in the video description to prusaprinters.org to get the STL files for these roof plugs. I have some pictures and a little information about the parts here. Once you have the files, you can print them yourself or go to a 3D printing service online. Exometry.com will give you a quote after you upload the STL file. You'll have to make an account, which is annoying. Anyway, here it is. Select the units, it's millimeters. And the roof plugs are $13.96 each, or $45 for 4 of them. Right now I have the SLS process selected and nylon for the material. This is a great choice. You can change it by clicking Modify Part. SLS stands for Selective Laser Sintering. It's pretty awesome. FDM stands for Fused Deposition Modeling, and that's what my printer does. It basically melts the plastic on a little bit at a time. The laser thing is better. Nylon is the most flexible material, so just go with SLS and nylon. You'll get your parts in a week for about $45. That sounds like a good deal to me.
Well, that's all I have for now, and as always, thank you so much for watching my videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one.